this shit! This episode of Triple THS is brought to you by DraftKings.com. What's up, fight fans? I'm the TNA Wrestling and Mixed Martial Arts Tommy Toehold, and the suspension has finally been lifted. It is now time for Jon Jones to get busy living or get busy dying. He and Daniel Cormier are gonna hang out on a beach and rebuild an old boat. The boned one has officially served his suspension for whatever the fuck he did this time to whoever the fuck he did it to. I honestly don't even remember anymore. And things now officially move forward when he takes on the Bowser to his Mario, Daniel Cormier, at UFC 214 in just a few weeks.
It is literally so nice to be unsuspended from that suspension that I was under for whatever reason that I was under this one this time. Whatever it was, I'm sure I learned a valuable lesson or some shit. Life-changing moments and such. Let's fuck shit up.
I see you're back in the gym.
Oh, I've literally been back in the gym for some time now. Not that I need to train for any of my fights, but holy shit, imagine if I actually, like, try. The coaches, they have this thing they've got me on called a schedule?
A schedule?
Yes, that's the word. It's pretty neat. It's basically like they tell you when to be places on a regular basis, and it forms positive habits that allow me to focus my energy on becoming a better fighter. As if that was even possible. Can you imagine me getting any better than I already was? Who would even be able to train with me? See, before it was like a game. It was, how fucked up can I get before a fight and literally still win it? The Gustafson fight was pretty close to the limit. Respectfully, I had to actually sober up a little bit to make sure that I won that one. But my first fight with DC, my first fight with you, Daniel, I don't even remember the month that led up to that fight, or the fight itself, or many weeks following it. I watched the video of it just the other day, and I still kicked your ass. Literally 3 hours before our fight last time, Daniel, I was in the middle of the desert, gambling illegally on camel races, and sandblasting any hooker in a 3 mile radius, which was surprisingly a lot of them. Greg Jackson had to steal one of the camels, and throw me on it, and ride it back to the arena. There are still bookies looking for him to this day. I had just enough time to get my hands wrapped, and I still beat you so easily, Daniel. So now that I have this, say the word again, a schedule. Now that I have this schedule, you are literally so fucked. So fucked. You're fucked like a teen having premarital sex and smoking marijuana at Camp Crystal Lake.
John, what are your plans going forward if you do win in July?
After retiring Daniel and seeing his entire world crumble before him, I am going to Dairy Queen.
You're gonna go get ice cream.
Nope, Dairy Queen's the name of the dealer that sells the most fire-ass cocaine in the West. I'm in love with the cocoa. I'm just kidding, that's all behind me now.
He's back! See you tomorrow, fight fans!